Hey everybody, my name is Timothy Lee. I am originally from Lincoln, Nebraska. Live in Phoenix, Arizona right now. And I want to give you some ideas that we can talk about of starting your own business and being an entrepreneur. Growing up in Lincoln, Nebraska, I grew up in a family that wasn't necessarily entrepreneurs, but my dad always had two or three jobs. But I was always on the prowl for making money. I had a paper route, cutting grass, shoveling snow, you name it, we were going door to door to make money. And so that's kind of what started my whole deal in my life. When I was 22, we started a franchise. We were franchisees and ran that for about 8 or 9 years. And it was a Pro Image franchise, which was a team licensed shop. We did really well. Decided that we wanted something different, moved to Phoenix, Arizona, started the Perfectionist Cleaning Services, and ran that, now currently in operation for 26 years. And then in 2014, we started Special Ops Clean Team, which is the franchise that we are going to be talking about today. Over the years, you know, a lot of people say, hey, I want to be my own boss, I want to do my own thing, right? And careful what you wish for, although it's an amazing experience, but for some people it can be a miserable experience because they didn't plan, they didn't foresee what was going to come down the road. So when you're starting up a new business, you want to make sure that you have all your ducks in line, you make sure you have the financial wherewithal, support from your family, and then you can go for it. But until then, you got to have something that is like a niche market. Like with Special Ops Clean Team, it's a niche market. We're not a normal maid service. We thought outside of the box. I guess when you're starting your own business, a lot of people wake up one day and they come up with an idea and they say, hey, I want to start up my business, you know, what do you think? And I always tell people, I said, if you're not excited about it and you're not thinking about it, literally every minute of every day, maybe it's not right. And so that's my big thing when I've come up with ideas of starting a business or investing or doing anything that I do. Sometimes I get ahead of myself and I'll say, oh my gosh, that's a great idea. And then 3 days later, I lose that drive or that interest. If that drive and that interest of starting your business, that's my biggest takeaway right now, is you've got to have that fire in the belly. You've got to have that passion and that grit for what you want to do. And I truly believe a lot of people say, well, I'd like to do this, I'd like to do that. Find something that you're really good at from the start and then get great at it. And you know, they always say you put 10,000 hours into something, you're going to be really darn good at it. And I was just adding up the hours that I have well over 150 to 200,000 hours in what I've done. So I feel like I've mastered a lot of the stuff that we've done in our business, but every day you're still a learning curve. So you're tweaking your business all the time. It's never going to be a straight line. It's going to go up, it's going to go down, but ultimately it's a line that's going to eventually just keep going up and up and up and up. Number one would be vision. Vision is, you have to have that vision going into what you want to do. And you have to think, I think, 5, 10, 15 years down the road. I really do. I don't think tomorrow. Even though you need to worry, you didn't worry, but you have to take care of business tomorrow. But you have to have a plan where you really want to go. Interesting story. I went to Bondurant Racing School for a day. And I had the top driver there, they weren't that busy, and luckily he rode with me the whole day for 8 hours. And I remember one thing that really struck me, and I could apply it to running a business, is he said, what are you looking at? And I said, I'm looking at the front of the car. And he said, you're driving. He said, you need to look at where you're going. He said, you need to look down at the next turn and the car will take you there. And so that's kind of where the vision comes in, is like, you got to know where you want to go. And you have to always think, you can't think small, you have to think big. But I think a lot of people think way too small, like, oh, I just want to have one team and stuff. When I was cleaning on my own, literally from day one in 1995, my thought wasn't anything about me cleaning. It was about, I was crunching numbers in my head all day long. If I had four teams, I had five teams, I'd be doing $500,000 a year, then I'd be doing $1 million a year, then I'd be $2 million. So the numbers just kept going up and up. And that's where you have, your mindset, and that's where everything starts with, is your vision and your mindset has to flow with that. I've learned a lot over the years, and I guess my goals right now are to really help other people, mentor other people, and show them that there is a different way, a different lifestyle. Second quality of an entrepreneur is you need to have a driven attitude. You literally need to have a motor, right? You need energy. If you're passionate about something, that driven attitude is so much easier. What's hard is when people try to say, hey, I want to open up a restaurant, I want to do this. They know nothing about that business or that venture. So they get into something and then they lose their drive. They lose their attitude towards being successful. So it's important with that driven attitude, choose something. Like in my business, cleaning is a natural for me. I just absolutely love it, and it's still hard for me to get away from doing the physical cleaning because of the pride that I take, and I got that from my father, who was in the United States Air Force. I mean, he was a clean freak, you know, and that's the way that was the way he was taught in the military, right? His shoes were always shining, and he looked spot on, and so that's kind of where your attitude, and I would tell my team, you know, 50% of everything that happens in your life is your attitude. If you have a great attitude, you'll be successful. So, third quality, be you have a strong work ethic. You find some people that they're entrepreneurs, but they're not really, they really don't have that work ethic, meaning they're willing to put in a 12, 14, 16 hour day to get the job done. And when you're starting up any business or working for somebody and you want to grow with the company or you want to do your own gig, you're the man, you're the one that's, everybody's following your lead, right? And I always tell my teams, I say, look, if you're dragging and you're not up to snuff, don't expect your teammates, you know, to achieve success with you. I always kind of, I compare business to sports. Look at Tom Brady, right? I mean, that guy's a winner, and he's a winner, and what are the odds that he goes to a different team in the first year and wins the Super Bowl in his hometown? That's not by accident. Everybody that is on his team realizes that they have one goal, and that's the Super Bowl. And we have one goal in our business. We want to be the best. And in order to be the best, you've got to have a strong work ethic. You got to practice, you got to train, you got to learn, you got to read. I can talk about reading all day long, and we'll talk about it in later podcasts. But so much of the information that I have mustered over the years has been from reading, of course, and my on-the-job experience with what I do. But I've learned so much from other entrepreneurs and people that are, it's amazing what you can pull from just reading books and newsletters or anything that you can get your hands on. The fourth quality would be just to be honest and integrity. That's pretty simple, straightforward. But remember growing up, your parents would say, honesty is the best policy. And it really is, you know, and we're all gonna make mistakes. We're all gonna, you know, mess up, whether it be with our spouses or our children, in your business, with your teammates. But always be honest with them and be square with them. And I always tell my team, I can't tell you how many customers we have gotten back and how many ex-employees have come back to our team because we're always honest with them. And we admitted if we had made a mistake, and we let them know that, hey, we're here for you if you want to come back. And I can't tell you how many people that have came back. And my biggest takeaway from there is never burn bridges. Right, just never burn a bridge. You don't know, if you burn a bridge, there's so many opportunities that you're gonna fail on because of having that bridge gone. When that bridge is there, anybody can come back over and be a customer of yours. I mean, I couldn't even put a dollar figure together of all the business that we've generated from not doing that. And so I think that's important. Communication, they say when there's no communication, there's chaos. And I think anybody that's worked for any company or ran your own business, and I'm as guilty as the next, because sometimes you want to just take it all in and deal with it yourself. But I'm reading a new book called Tiger by the Tail, 99 Tactics of Business. And the author and his partner had a business together, and they had a special thing called the Scotch meeting. And it was when they both had an event, and they said, we're going to drink, we're going to go have a glass of scotch, and we're going to tell each other what we think about everything that's going on in our business. And he goes, and we're not leaving until it's resolved. And it's kind of what I think about communication. I think that's so true. So I think two of the biggest reasons for business failure is, number one, is trying to get into something that is completely duplicating what your competitors are doing. So if you're going to open up a restaurant or you're going to open a cleaning service and you're doing the exact same thing that your competitors are doing, what advantage do you really have? I always say building a better mousetrap, right? You got to come up with a business idea that's different. You know, like Dutch Brothers kind of went after Starbucks, right? But their claim to fame is having a conversation with their clients, and people love that. They were like, that's kind of their deal, right? So on the cleaning side, with our niche market, it was, we didn't want to be your typical maid service with Special Ops Clean Team. We wanted to go above and beyond that. We wanted to tackle the bigger jobs. We wanted to be able to be the one-stop shop for our customers. So if a customer needed their house clean, we'd say, hey, like, what about your carpets? Do you need your windows done? So a $500 job turned into a $1,000 job, turned into a $2,000 job. So it just, the numbers just keep getting bigger and bigger. Obviously, you have to have the talent to be able to pull that off, but that's our business model. And you have to have a great business model. And that's why it takes a lot of thought and planning and scoping out your competition and say, what are they doing? What can we do different that would make our business more successful? Number two, lack of sales. They always say three, there could be three there, lack of equity, lack of money to start up a business. That's just bad planning from the start. But lack of sales is basically you're not generating enough sales for the company. And some people say, well, that's because I don't have money to advertise, I don't have this. Well, that's something when you pre-plan for. But a lot of it is just grinding, right? Are you a grinder? And people that really want something, you got everything in your life is invested in this company. You've sold your house, you've got a second mortgage, you're working a second job, you've downsized your whole life to make this happen, and now you're sitting on your duff and you're not going out and generating revenue. The only way a business will survive is revenue. You can have the prettiest office, you can have all the uniforms, you can do the whole nine yards, but if you're not mustering up business, you're gonna fail. And so you don't have to be a great salesperson. If you have a great product, and I always tell people love to spend money with people they love. My mom used to say this all the time when we'd run into a situation with a teacher at school, because I used to always get in trouble, and she'd always say, kill them with kindness, so the teachers love me. So so that's kind of where I apply a lot of my worldly life that I've lived in and all the things that I've done, apply it to my business. And it really works. And I think we make life and business too complicated. Keep it simple. With Special Ops Clean Team, as a franchiser, we have already paved that path for you. So failure really is not an option for us. We know we've got a successful brand. We have a successful model. If you're willing to come on board and put the effort in and listen to what we've done, we've already eliminated 95% of the mistakes that most people deal with when they're starting up a new startup. So when you come on board as a franchisee, the success rate is unbelievable. And if you look at the market today, most of the franchises, the number of volume, I think, and I don't have the correct number, but I think it's about 50% of all money generated in the United States is from franchises. So that's a big number. That's trillions of dollars. And why is that? Because they've already got that model. It's proven, right? Like McDonald's, it's like, you know, Kentucky Fried Chicken or any business that's out there, they've built that brand, they built that name. And that's what we want to do with Special Ops Clean Team. And we're looking for people that are excited about really with that strong work ethic and want to be successful. And maybe break that chain in their family. You know, everybody in their family, maybe people, they didn't go to school, they're all working subpar jobs. And I've met so many people that are really hungry for that right now. And they're trying to muster up the money to get the thing off the ground. And that's where we come into play. We're going to help them build this business venture for them. So there are three things that I would use first before starting a business. I would take these three things into consideration. Number one is you need a game plan, right? You need to say, okay, this is the business that I want to get into. What's my competition? How much money do I need to make? What kind of revenue can I make from that company? You're crunching the numbers in your head and you're doing your homework, right? A lot of people sometimes just, they get an idea, but they don't really think it through. And maybe they start playing around with it and they start investing, putting some money into it. And then all of a sudden they run short because they didn't realize that, hey, this is a tough business to actually make a profit. Revenue sometimes can be easy. It's actually bringing it to bottom line and taking something home is the hardest part, you know? So I know a lot of, it's kind of funny because running our company, our team sees a lot of the dollars coming through, right? And it's some big dollars, but they don't see the overhead that goes into what produced that, the advertising, the manpower, the buildings, the electric, everything that goes into that. And then at the end of the day, you pray that you have something left over that you can use as your earnings and then take that money and just keep rebuilding your company. So that would be number one. So number two would be, how much cash do I need in order to take this venture on? And that's probably the biggest thing that I've seen most people right now. I see so many people that have a drive and a heart for running their own business, but they don't have enough money. And it could be the nail in the coffin if they don't have it. Here's an interesting story. I had somebody that was interested in a franchise, but all she had was the money for the franchise fee. Well, I told her, I'm not going to take your money, a franchise fee, if you don't have the money to run the business. So it's a mute point. Because there are some companies that would do that. It would never happen at Special Ops Clean Team. You have to have enough money because I don't want to set you up for failure. And so that's really important. That you do your math and do your numbers and listen, if you have the money to any business and you have the will and the passion and the grit to do it, you can do it and you can do anything you want. Number three, I talked about this earlier, is the passion, right? Do you have passion for running a cleaning business, for example? Are you passionate about cleaning? If you're saying, oh, I don't even like to clean, I don't enjoy it, well, maybe this isn't the right thing for you, correct? But there's a lot of people out there that are like me. They have that something about, I don't know what it is, but when I go into a dirty home, it just, my juices get flowing. I'm like, I want to make this thing shine. And I want those customers, when I walk out of that door, they're going to say, thank you so much. And that gives chills up my spine, because that's what a lot of the work that we do, that's what we do. We go into a lot of really dirty homes, and some of them have been really neglected. We can make them look like brand new. A lot of potential franchisees come to us and they want to know, what are you going to do for us? How are you going to make our opportunity better for us and easier? And I think the tools that we use, number one is training. It's huge. You know, we're not going to just send them a videotape and say, here, go for it. They're literally going to spend 6 days at our corporate office, okay? Learning everything from selling to marketing to cleaning the homes to carpet cleaning to window, everything that we do, they're going to learn. And not only are they going to learn that, they're going to learn everything, the 26 years of the perfectionist and special ops cleaning that I'm bringing to the table, everything that I know. And not only that, but all the stuff that I've learned since I was a young kid, just anything about business, we want to be in their ear and be a mentor, right? Just like a coach, almost like a coach, where we're following them around all the time. And then they'll have, we call that boot camp, and then we have boot camp live, where we actually go out and spend a whole week with their team and the owners and go into the homes and physically do the work or sit in the office and actually do phone calls and role play and taking live calls from customers and evaluating how they sell and what everything that we're teaching them is obviously for their benefit. You know, we do not want anybody to fail on our watch. And so that's really important to me. I have a deep desire for people to be successful in life. And I think if you have a somewhat of a game plan put together and they can follow our lead as a franchisor, we can show them success. We've already proven that we can do it, and we're not anything special. You know, I'm definitely not the smartest person in the world, so I can tell you that most of mine is driven with my attitude and my work ethic. And if you have that, you can, like anything, with our team, we can teach them to do anything. It's, do you have the drive to do it? If you have no drive, you won't be successful at anything, so it doesn't matter what you're gonna do. So there are three types of business models. Number one is working for somebody else, which can be a great, great opportunity. You can move up the corporate chain and eventually be a CEO, whatever you wanna do. This is the biggest challenge for people that wanna start up a business. When they're working for somebody else, and they might enjoy it, but is it the security of the check, the health insurance, everything that they have coming in and walking away from that? And that's a scary, scary thing. And so I know we've already encountered that with some people. They're working, one of the gentlemen has a great job right now, and he's like, I wanna work for myself so bad, but I don't know, you don't know the end result, right? Like anything in life, so there's a risk. Are you willing to take that risk? The good news is that with Special Ops, we're here to help you, right? So if you are working for somebody else and you want to make that leap, go for it, you know. The second business model that I want to talk about is basically doing it on your own, a startup. Coming up with the name, the brand, everything that entails starting a business, which can be difficult because if you've never done it before, you don't know exactly what you're doing, so you're going to need some help. The number three is a franchise model, which is obviously the most popular model in the United States and maybe even the world. Is the path has already been paved, right? So you're not going to be out there on your own. There's no free lunch, right? Everything you do, I think Donald Trump even said this, and if they talk about this, but he just said anything great. Is it worth doing, right? Is it worth doing? If there's an end result where you feel like, hey, this is something I want to do, you got to work at it. And so that goes back to hard work, you know, your work ethic, your attitude. And I really believe if you have that desire in your heart where you want to, you're passionate about something, you can do it. So. The benefits of Special Ops Clean Team, I truly believe, is that we've already taken all of the hard work out of the process of building a company. So it's already there. Now it's just handing it over to a franchisee like yourself and saying, we're going to show you exactly what we did to be successful, and we're going to just lay it over and you're going to follow our lead. 95% of the problems have already been taken care of. So you're gonna run into your own little tweaks here and there. But for the most part, I compare it to like when you're going on a hike and you're just going on a hike. You just go into a mountain area and you've never been there before and you start walking up wherever and there's no path. Well, you're gonna run into trouble, right? You're gonna run into cactus, you're gonna run into rattlesnakes, you're gonna run into who knows what. You might not have water when you go on track. We've already laid that out for you. We have the path laid out. You might stray off the path now and then, but we're going to keep you on the path for success because your success is our success. So it's a two-way street. And that's one big thing about franchising is both sides win. When one side loses, the other side loses. So it's a win-win for this whole process. So we're excited about looking for people that have that strong work ethic and that want to be successful. There is a path to success, and we feel like Special Ops Clean Team is one of the greatest opportunities in America. And we plan to be in every state at some point in time because we know that it's going to be contagious and that people are going to catch on. And you know what? The most important thing is, do our customers love this business model? And they do. As we wrap this up today, I want to give you some of my final thoughts on starting up your own business, specifically Special Ops Clean Team. But I really believe in my heart of hearts that if you really want to run your own business and live the American dream. That's what everybody talks about, right? Why do people move here from countries all over the world and try to get into America? They want that opportunity. And you already live in this country. You have that opportunity, so we don't want you to squander it. So I truly believe that you don't want that regret later in life. And we can come up with all the excuses in the world. I'm too young, I'm too old, I don't have any money, I'm divorced, I've got three kids, I have already worked two jobs, whatever. You're always gonna come up with something in life that keeps you from doing something, right? Whether that's starting a business or getting married or having kids or taking that new job. But starting your own business, it takes a lot of willpower and a lot of drive. And we don't want you to miss that opportunity. I guess one of the biggest things that I don't want you to do is regret. I mean, think about the people that invested in Amazon or bought Bitcoin early on, and people said they were crazy, like, oh my gosh, those are nothing, right? Well, let's fast forward 20, 30 years, you're a multimillionaire right now. Same thing with any business. You could be at the ground floor opportunity of a great opportunity that 20 years from now, you want life-changing rewards, right? Life-changing experiences. And the things, success doesn't just make you successful, it can make your whole family successful. It has a trickle-down effect, right? Maybe you wanna break that chain in your family where you feel like, oh my gosh, my whole family, nobody's successful. I wanna be that one. Be that one. What are you waiting for? And I think the biggest thing is that my door is always open for you. And I want to thank everybody for listening to this podcast and realize that I don't have all the answers, but I can tell you from the experiences that I've done, it can be done. And because if you ask my parents, they'll tell you I was not a straight A student, you know. I was lucky if I got, you know, C's and D's. So, but that's my point is that anybody can do this. So don't think that you can't do it, because you can do it. Henry Ford said, you're right whether you think you're right or wrong. If you think you're wrong, right? If you think you can't do something, there's no way in whole hell you're gonna do it. And if you think you can do it, you can. My granddaughter, Ashlyn, the other day did a pull-up. She's only like 4 years old, right? And then we wanted her to do another one. She goes, I can't. And I said, never use the word can't, because can't should not be in anybody's vocabulary, right? We need to all pursue and persevere. And if we have that drive in us, there's nothing that can stop you. And Special Ops Clean Team is a recipe for success. Thank you so much. And contact us. You can call us, you can email us your questions. Even if you just have a question, email me with a question and say, hey, I'm thinking about doing this. And maybe it has nothing to do with cleaning or anything else, but you have a business question for that matter. We'll answer your questions, we wanna talk. So if you've got a strong work ethic, you're gonna be super successful. Those are the kind of people we're looking for right now. And I really believe that if you come on board with us, we will help you. We'll help you succeed. We want you to succeed, because we love working with people that have a strong work ethic and desire and a great attitude towards life.